today we learn how to alphabetize items in Excel. Let's say you have this name list and you want the names to show up in last name order from A to Z. We can just click any cell in the last name column, go to the Data tab, and click the A to Z icon. And you can see that there's also an option to sort in the reverse order, which we can do by clicking Z to A. That was super easy. This method works really well because on this data set, one, we're sorting by columns. Two, Excel recognized that the first row is a header row, so it didn't sort that with the list of items below. And three, columns A and B are elements of a single data set, so Excel knew that the rows should be kept together when a column is sorted. Sometimes, though, one or more of these isn't the case, and the result you get when you press A to Z or Z to A isn't what you expected. For example, with this list of books, we might want to sort by classification so that fiction books will be together and nonfiction books will be together, but within each group, we also want to sort alphabetically by the author's name. This is called multi-level sorting. For this task, the sort icon works better because it gives us more options and more control over how our data is sorted. To use this option, we click anywhere within the dataset, go to the Data tab, and click the Sort command. Excel automatically detects the dataset to be sorted and displays the Sort dialog box on our screen. So here we click the Sort by drop-down arrow, and select the classification column, because that's the first column we want to sort by. The data will be sorted based on the cell values and in A to Z order. To add a second sorting level, we click Add Level. If you're using a Mac, there's a plus sign that will add a second level. And here you select Author. This will also be sorted from A to Z, and now we click OK. And here we have all the fiction books together, all the non-fiction books together, and within each group, they're sorted alphabetically by the name of the author. Have you ever wanted to alphabetize rows in a dataset? On this sheet, we have the number of book copies available by author. Again, we need the sort icon so that we'll get the option to sort by row. So let's go to Data, and the sort icon is here. This dataset doesn't have a clear header row, and sometimes Excel isn't able to figure out on its own what should and shouldn't be sorted when the header row isn't obvious. So it's usually best to highlight the actual dataset to be sorted, and since we don't want column A sorted, we leave that out of the highlighted area. Click the sort icon, and because we want to sort by row, we select Options and choose Sort Left to Right. Click OK. And since we're sorting by the name of the author, we want to sort by row 1 from A to Z. We click OK. And now we have the authors A to Z. Here are some troubleshooting tips for when you're trying to sort data alphabetically in Excel. One common problem is that the header row gets sorted among data. This is either because Excel didn't recognize that you had a header row when you pressed the A to Z icon, or you forgot to tick My Data Has Headers. To correct this problem, undo, and either choose Sort, My Data Has Headers, and Excel will highlight only the area to be sorted, and click OK. Or we could do that manually. Highlight the area, click Sort. There's no need to check My Data Has Headers, and sorting by column B will sort our list in last name order. Another problem could be that Excel only alphabetized a portion of your data set. So here, maybe you selected a cell within column B, clicked A to Z, and Excel only sorted the first few values. This happens because there's a break or gap within the data set, so Excel interprets this as two different sets of data. To correct this, we can either remove the blank row Or if we need to keep that blank row, we can just highlight the area to be sorted, use the sort icon, and select the column that we should use for sorting. Click OK, and everything is now sorted. What if you get this warning message? What does it mean? It means you highlighted an area to be sorted, but Excel thinks your data set is larger than what you selected because there seems to be more data right next to it. If you're sure you didn't make a mistake, click Continue with the current selection and sort. This means that only these cells will be sorted and these will remain unchanged. If you did make a mistake, then choose Expand the selection. Excel will now sort all the adjacent cells, treating each row as one unbroken set of data. Click Sort, and now we've sorted by destination in alphabetical order, keeping each passenger going to their original destination. And that's how you put things in alphabetical order in Excel. Hopefully, you picked up a tip or two. Practice your sorting skills now by downloading the practice file in the description.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on goskills.com. Click the link in the description.